And we're live. Okay, magandang gabi po sa inyo lahat, mga Entor trainees, mga mentees natin all over the Philippines, all over the world, all over the world. Okay, nagbabalik na naman ang inyong lingkod, Mentor Myron Santana, your buddy to success, your corporate Entor trainer, and your soft skills go-to guy. At ito po ang pangilan na to. Episode 12 na eh, biruin mo yun. Nakakarami na tayong episodes ng ating weekly online talk show entitled hashtag Myron Kaming Advice. At talaga namang Myron Kaming Advice every Saturday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. kasama syempre, well, for this special season, kasama natin one after another ang mga kapwa natin, top 100 Filipinos to follow on LinkedIn for 2023. At muli, paulit-ulit ko itong sinasabi every week, pero hindi ako magsasawa. Maraming salamat po ulit sa inyong suporta, kundi po dahil sa inyo, wala mga additional people out there ang magiging successful or more successful sa kanilang pinasok na experience sa corporate world or negosyo sa entrepreneurship, no? And dahil po yan sa inyo, mga kapwa ko, top 100 Filipinos to follow on LinkedIn. At syempre, ngayong gabi, nagbabalik na naman tayo para sa isa na namang source of inspiration and motivation. Pero bago ang lahat, syempre, napaka-importante naman nagdaang araw. No, this is a long weekend, pero ito yung ating special time to recollect, syempre, to ask for forgiveness, and to spend more quality time to communicate with our Creator, our beloved Lord, our God. And nasaan man po kayo ngayon? Ako personally, hindi ako naka-vacation, long vacation with family kasi mayroong mga paparating na training schedules for April. To papasok na buwan na talaga namang nag-rush ako na tapusin yung mga kinustomize ko or creating from scratch na mga modules. Kaya as much as I would like to, or my family and I would like to go on vacation talaga, nandito lang tayo sa opisina, okay? Pero okay lang yun kasi sabi nga nila, no, ang atin namang pakikipag-usap sa Panginoon ay walang pinipiling lugar. Kahit nasaan naman tayo, pwede tayo makipag-usap sa Kanya. Ang pinakamahalaga doon, syempre, sincere, solemn, at talagang we all lift it back to Him. Okay? So, bago ang lahat, alam ko excited na kayong matuto, pero syempre kailangan ko pong strongly encourage ang lahat na tulungan ako mag-advocate for, syempre, inspiration, motivation, and learning. Kaya tulungan niyo po akong i-share itong ating live stream. Napakaganda po ng topic. Nagaganap po ito simulcast across 3 different platforms. Nasa Facebook po ito, sa aking Mentor Myron Santana page, nasa LinkedIn po ito sa aking profile, at nasa YouTube din po sa aking channel, Mentor Myron Santana din. Okay, so hanapin nyo na Mentor Myron Santana or the Corporate Entor Trainer. Again, alam ko excited na ang bawat isa, kaya ano ba ang pag-uusapan natin sa gabing ito? Ang pag-uusapan po natin sa gabing ito ay, ayan. Yan, best practices for acing your interview and negotiating your salary. So dalawa yung target audience natin sa gabing ito. Syempre, nandiyan yung mga fresh graduates na maghahanap o naghahanap na ng trabaho, and gusto nyo makakuha ng best practices sa isang expert, experienced practitioner, kung paano ba ma-pull off yung interview na yan. Okay? And syempre, kung may pangangailangan na i-negotiate yung offer, ayun din. So malalaman natin ng mga tips and techniques paano ba makumbinsi yung recruitment professional na i-consider yung ating request. And syempre, pwede rin po ito sa mga would-be leaving their current company and would be looking around for a company to network with, ayan, or to partner with. Yun yung lagi kong tawag na, not just work for but partner with, because employees are not merely resources, we are business partners. Ayan, so yun lagi ang tawag ko do pag naghahanap ng panibagong alam mo yon, yung it's a fill up na libro sa ating buhay, you know. And okay, so yun lang naman. Once again, let's keep on sharing this. All right, so without further ado, it is with pride and honor to introduce to you our guest resource person for tonight. Ang ating pong guest resource person ay isang experienced talent acquisition professional and leader with a background in different industries like pharmaceutical, shared services, BPO, IT, property technology, real estate, and startup industries while supporting stakeholders based in different parts of the globe. At kagaya po ng inyong lingkod, she is also a resource speaker, trainer, and a part of the top 100 most influential Filipino women on LinkedIn for 2022 and 2023, and part of the top 100 Filipinos to follow on LinkedIn in 2023. So samahan niyo po ako na i-welcome ang ating guest, resource person. Pero bago natin papasukin ang ating guest, syempre, ipakita muna natin sa inyong lahat. Ayan, si Coach Lawrence Aimi Mutia. Pero sabi niya, tawagin ko na lang siyang Lawrence. So Lawrence, good evening.
Hi, good evening everybody. I hope everyone's having their restful weekend and the restful Holy Week for everyone.
I'm pretty sure about that. Yan. So si Lawrence, nag-interview na kami kung ang what kept her busy these past few days. Kaya sa kanya na lang manggaling uli yun. Okay? Para sa inyo namang benefit. So Lawrence, kumusta? How have you spent your long weekend? Of course, hindi pa tutapos. May Linggo pa tayo.
Of course, just caught up with personal stuff, personal errands. I did not leave Manila, just like you, just because I like the tranquility na okay, walang ganong traffic, walang ganong tao, and I don't want to be stressed with the traffic left and right if I go back to the province, kasi I originated from the province, and of course, sa mga pet lovers dyan, of course, you get the point that nag-alaga ka ng pet para magbantay, although my pets are cats, pero hindi ka aalis kasi walang magbabantay.
Oh, nga. No. Talaga, ano, kahit sabihin mong ipabantay mo sa iba, sino yung iba na tinutukoy? Ako lang, di ba?
Yes.
So, do you live by yourself if you don't mind? Kaya talaga mo walang mapag-iwanan ng mga beloved pets natin?
Yes, and the challenge is, the challenge is since I live alone and it's 1 versus 5. I have 5 cats at home.
I see. Pero hopefully, yan ang, yung mga cats mo ay talaga namang source ng iyong stress relieving or relaxation after ng whole day's work, na?
Of course, of course.
Ayan. By the way, bago tayo magsimula sa ating kwentuhan na pwede rin maging kwentawanan, kwentawanan, tawag ko doon eh, kwentuhang may tawanan. Pwede rin naman, depende sa flow ng pag-uusap natin, Lawrence. No? So, acknowledge muna natin yung mga bumate. Ayan. Ito ay sa mga ating kaibigan, si Mr. Antonio Sulaiman. And external training providers yan. Good evening, mentor and coach Lawrence Aimi. Okay?
Hi!
Salamat po sa inyong attendance. And katulad po nang nabanggit ko kanina, kasi napakagandang topic nito. Eh. I'm pretty sure si Lawrence would agree na talagang dapat maraming makapanood nito, maraming makapakinig dito. And syempre, hindi naman ito yung tipo pagkatapos ng live stream natin, mawawala na. So kung na-miss out nyo ito because you have other priorities for this time today, eh pwede nyo na pong balikan doon sa Facebook, sa YouTube, sa LinkedIn. Ayan. So huwag kang maglala, Lawrence. Marami pa makakahabol nito at may matututunan dito. Hindi ito mawawala online. Resibo na ito. Okay. So are you ready, Lawrence?
Ready when you are.
Ayan. Alam mo, napakaganda ng topic mo, no? And I'm pretty sure this is already one of your advocacies, right? And before this has become your advocacy, syempre nakita ko naman yung profile mo talagang ever since you graduated from college. Talagang talent acquisition through and through na talaga, no?
Yes.
So number one, ano ba yan? Intentional ba yan? Talaga bang gusto mo pasukin yung mundo ng talent acquisition o nagkataon lang?
Well, actually not intentional. It's just that back then, yung una kong role, it was in a BPO company. Ang pinagdadasal kong makuha is a compensation and benefits specialist role. Tapos, nung I was watching it, binabantay ako siya in Job Street, nag-apply ako. Tapos, after a couple of days, nawala na siya. So sabi ko, ay, hindi yata talaga siya para sa akin. Back then, I was already working as a marketing personnel for a small BPO company in Batangas City. So from my OJT, inofera nila ako. Kaya lang sabi ko, in my heart of hearts, I really wanted to practice HR because I'm a BS psychology graduate. Tapos, a couple of days after that, syempre, lungkot-lungkutan pa. The former recruitment manager of that particular site went to my mom. My mom also works in the same company. Saying, uy, may opening kami sa talent acquisition. Baka gusto ng anak mo, itry lang niya mag-apply. So, I applied. Actually, it was common knowledge that I was the second in line for the role. Just because yung una daw candidate nag-decline.
So thank you sa kanya, nag-decline siya. No?
Yeah, so normally kasi, to be honest with you, Myron, this role, the role that I had back then, it normally requires 1 year of BPO experience as an agent. Mm-hmm. So ako naman noon, I was fresh out of college. So siguro tiningnan nila if it's gonna be feasible na kaya-kaya nating magkaroon ng fresh grad. And sobrang thankful ako. Kasi sinugalan talaga ako ng mga boss ko up until the time I got promoted and then up until the time that I got relocated to Manila na.
Ang ganda ng mentality nung nag-recruit sa'yo kasi alam mo, isa yan sa mga problema eh, no, ng mga job seekers, di ba? May mga employers, through of course their recruitment people, na naghahanap ng may experience. Eh, paghahanapan mo nga ng experience, eh, naghahanap din siya ng experience. Yes. So, di ba parang it's so ironic na fresh grad nga, eh, wala pang experience. Ang meron lang yan, pinaka-best would be OJP. Tapos eto pa, naghahanap ng may experience. So ano na ngayon na kinabukasan pag-asa ng mga fresh grads, di ba? So kailangan talagang baguhin yung ganong mindset ng mga employers, eh, no? And Lorenzo, I'm not sure if you would agree, no? Pero okay lang, I would like your thoughts as well on this, di ba? Nag-shift tayo sa K-12 hoping na we would align with the international standards. Pero ang hindi nag-a-align pa din, yung mindset din ng mga, hindi ko naman nila lahat, pero karamihan din sa employers na college graduate pa rin ang hinahanap, eh paano natin mabibigyan ng pag-asa, right? Or chance itong effectiveness ng K-12. Eh, mindset nga ng employers, eh, college graduate pa din. Yes. Tama ba?
Yes, I agree with you. I do get, and we acknowledge naman, no, that we wanted to align internationally. Pero, to be honest, ito yung question na, okay, we're aligning internationally in the years of education. Pero the question, is it the quality? At par ba siya internationally? So yun yung mindset ko na sabi ko, at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter. Okay, nag-K-12 ka, okay, and then what? And then you went to college, and then right now, you graduated. Ano yung value nung plus 2 years? I maybe, of course, this is an opinion of mine. I did not reach the K-12. My younger brother reached it. As early as his grade 9 ba yun? He already grade knows kung anong track na yung kukunin niya because it's required. Pero alam mo yun, parang sabi ko, unfair naman na parang, paano kung magbago yung isip mo in the next 2 years, di ba? So, I actually like the idea, pero we should have, of course, banked on the quality of education as well.
Exactly. Kung magkukunda ka talaga ng root cause analysis, eh, saan ba tayo lahat ililid nito? Diba kahit anong ipasok mo na system sa Pilipinas, kung yung basic, yung foundational na education ng ating mga kabataan, eh kailangan pang strengthen further, you know?
Yes, and I actually, it's somewhat relevant to your career experience as well, no? So hindi naman to bago na, of course, I'm actually fairly young. I'm actually 32 years old. Thank you. So I'm 32 years old and hindi naman siguro lahat ng kumpanya, but I've had experiences back then, mostly in local organizations stating na, ay, ang bata mo pa kasi for a senior role or for a manager position. And I've experienced that before. I'm very grateful sa mga employers ko for banking on me. Hindi nila tinignan kung gano'ng kabata. Because yun nga yung sinasabi ko eh. We're banking on the years of experience. Just like the K-12. We're banking on the years of education. Pero the quality ba? Is it there? So yun. I think this is also one of the medyo contestable discussions sa mga recruiters right now is that we all have tenure, we all have that years of experience, but is the quality the same? So, yun din yung isang magandang key takeaway in this That's session right. for me.
Very well said. Actually, kaya lang tayo napunta doon kasi gusto ko talagang pasalamatan at syempre purihin yung nagbigay sa inyo ng chance back then, di ba? Yes, kung hindi kasi yes. Very positive, very welcoming, and very, I'll give you a chance, yung kanyang mindset. Of course,
yes.
The Lawrence Mutia well. For that company will not be able to join their company, di ba?
It's funny as well. I failed the initial interview. back then. So thank you Miss Cha and Miss Neng for passing me kahit nabagsak ako. I failed the initial interview kasi sinabi ko nun gusto ko mag-law school. So back then, syempre, our role, I work in the BPO, of course, high volume, high demand, very dynamic. Minsan nagsa-Saturday work kami. So syempre, hindi nila mag-guarantee yun. And I do understand that. I acknowledge that. I've worked in the industry for 4 years initially as a recruiter and right now as a project manager. And tapos after nun, parang nung sinabi sa mommy ko na, uy, bagsak yung anak mo kasi hindi mo yata tinuro ang sumagot sa interview. So, that's one key point. In-interview pa rin ako nung back then, she was a senior recruiter. My boss back then when she was a senior recruiter. Ngayon, director na siya for recruitment. So, I'm very, very grateful na parang sabi ko, thank you po, pinasa niyo ako kahit I initially failed the initial interview. But I passed. All of the assessments and the likes, I did the very same assessments ng mga agents back then. So same. I was in, sabi ko nga, kung hindi ako papasa ng recruiter, mag-i-agent ako, and that's okay. I actually, syempre, my mom worked in the industry. Technically, for lack of a better term, I was a nepo baby. Pero sobrang thankful ako kasi they banked on me up until the time na nag-justify sila ng promotion, even though it's an off-cycle promotion. Tapos, nung paalis na ako at 2015, kinausap ako noon na parang, ang motivation mo lang ba to move to another company is dahil gusto mo lang lumipat ng Manila? And said yes, sabi nila, we have a position that will open at this particular site. Tingnan mo if you like it. Ask the director if you want to do the interview. And I did the interview and I was very grateful na they gave me the role. I was actually the youngest in my level back then. So parang it's kind of, natutuwa naman ako na parang if you're, looking back, I was very, I learned from the best of the best in the industry when I started. So parang yun foundation ko, kumbaga, for lack of a better term, batak sa work, pero the values are there. Sobrang, sobrang thankful ako dun sa company na yun. Although, of course, at the end of the day, hindi siya, of course, I have to spread my wings and fly. I had a choice. I was referred, by the way, by one of my previous hiring managers. Tapos sabi niya, gusto kitang kunin kasi so i-refer kita dun sa current employer ko. So dun ako napadpad from BPO to information technology. So sobrang grateful din ako sa nag-hire sa akin doon kasi the role requires an IT recruitment experience which I did not have back then. So, they also gamble na sige, try natin i-hire siya. So, yun.
Meron akong curious question, Lawrence, kasi baga I've been hearing from you that thank you because they've gambled on you. But I'm pretty sure na meron silang nakita sa'yo eh. Kahit na yung una, you did not, you came short of the initial interview. Tapos, ito namang kinukwento mo just now is merong kulang sa hinahanap din ng qualifications eh. Pero ano sa tingin mo ang nakita nila sa iyo na they gave you the chance, you know, if I may use your words, so they gambled on you. Na pwede rin siguro nating maging tip, although mamaya pa tayo mag-i-in-depth doon sa how to ace the interviews, ha, pwede rin nating ibigay na tip sa mga taong naghahanap ng trabaho para makonsider sila. Go ahead.
Siguro tinignan nila yung grit ko sa work. Kasi back then, when I was still studying, lahat ng racket pinasok ko. So I did, nagturo ako sa Vietnamese ng English. I was a former editor-in-chief of the student publication of Batangas State University. Nung tatatlo pa lang yon. So I managed like 8 versus 10 of the campuses at Batangas State dun sa student publication side of things. Tapos nagre-recruit ako
year-year. Very active pala sa ano, yes. Mga student
players, ha? Yes, tapos sabi ko, kaya ako lang siya ginagawa nun kasi May konting honorarium. Tapos, syempre, binibigyan ako ng mga tutis ko ng sweldo. I also did briefly, actually, nag-2 days ako before on a large fast food chain. Kaya lang hindi ko talaga kaya. So much respect to those persons working in the food industry.
Very physically demanding, huh?
Yes, hindi ko alam kung paano nyo siya nagagawa. Pero sobrang I salute you guys doon. Siguro nakita nila yung grit ko na I'm gonna do this. At the end of the day, kapag sinabi ng boss ko, syempre, of course, hindi dahil people pleaser ako. There were some instances as well that I had to put my foot down and say no. But the grit is there eh, na pag sinabi ko, I will learn this, I will learn this. When I tell you that I will deliver this on X day, I will deliver this. So, naalala ko nun, yung when I was still in the BPO sector as a recruiter, kapag sinabing, sino may gustong Saturday operations, tapos may mga pagkakataon na sinasabi ng boss ko, wag na ikaw, magpahinga ka na, kasi every Saturday, ikaw na lang yung pumapasok. And sabi ko nga, okay.
Magandang tayo ng tindahan, tawag doon.
Yes, oo. Pero it gave me an opportunity kasi nung time na yun, ako lang yung senior recruiter na pumapasok. So kung sino man yung ibang pumasok, parang ano, parang you will be acting as a site OIC. So it also helped me with my managerial skills. So hindi nila nakikita yun. Ako, nakikita ko lang na ay dagdag sweldo kasi rest day OT, tapos matatapat pa siya na holiday, no? So triple pay. So ngayon, parang sabi ko, looking back, sabi ko, oh my God, it's training me to be in that position, like years following that. So, yun, parang nakita, ang reason naman nun, actually, I also asked that to my manager when I was hired in that IT company. Sabi ko, bakit niyo po ako hinire? Wala naman po akong IT recruitment experience. Ang kalaban ko in that role is actually small world, naging team member ko pa siya later on in our careers. Tapos ano siya, she was a very technical recruiter. Tapos sabi ko, tinanong niya ako, sabi niya kasi, yung giggle na pag nag-hire ka, pag sinabi di-deliver mo to, kasi dun sa role ko, I was not measured. Kasi in the BPO, you need to fill the classes. You need to deliver it on a certain date.
Matindi measures talaga.
Yes. Sabi ko nga, tapos nag-corporate recruitment ako, ang measurement namin is time to fill and time to onboard lang. So very, very different. Tiningnan nila yung grit ko na makahire. Yung, kasi I worked in the BPO. Siyempre, yung gigil mo mag-hire, kailangan nandun. Tapos sabi nila, everything can be trained. And even right now in my role, in Concentric, so sobrang thankful din ako sa boss ko who hired me, to our VP who hired me. When this role was opened, I know that sabi ko, pwede kaya ako mag-apply because this is a project manager. I did not have the formal title, but I did project management every once in a while. And they also took a chance na, okay, sige, let's try. And I was trained by the best of the best within the company. So day one pa lang, I was already placed with the project management team. Tapos sila yung una kong makakausap. Tapos really catching up lang on the recruitment process. So sobrang, oh my God, sobrang grateful din ako sa current employer ko. Kasi lahat naman halos, if you're gonna take a look at my experience, I did not normally meet, hindi naman I did not meet the minimum requirement, but there are transferable skills naman. And this is also something that I would want to highlight, no? This is also one tip that we will discuss later on. Highlight your transferable skills. So imagine, wala naman akong experience back then na mag-hire for international recruitment, pero I was hired for a big pharma company as a senior recruiter for India. So ngayon, wala, meron akong project management experience, pero it's not really as formal as it can be, pero ang role ko ngayon, project manager. So, alam mo yun, just understand what are your transferable skills in the role that you're applying for and who knows. And one thing as well, do not self-reject. Parang sabi mo, ay, hindi ako
exactly.
Maka, hindi ako, di ba, hindi ako qualified.
Right. So, yung mga ganun. Self-imposed limitations. So, your worst enemy is yes. Yourself. Huh?
Yes, that is correct.
Very well said. Ayan. Sobrang ano eh, excited na akong itanong yung follow-up question eh. Pero bago yan, i-acknowledge muna natin ang mga nagko-comment. So, si Just a Normal Day, good evening mentor, may kasunod pa yan. Thank you for this very informative show. At ang ating kaibigan at kapwa Top 100, si Coach Yan Yan Labonete, shout out. Ayan.
Ayan yan. So I also did a session with her on the same topic.
Sa kanyang community.
Yes, so I'm very grateful. Thanks Yan Yan.
Yeah, so shout out sa ating mga kaibigan, Just Accounting People's community. And then we have here Maribik Kasipong. Miss DIY Hacks, ito ata yung mga kapo natin YouTuber. Ayan. Hello, Miss. Salamat sa suporta, guys. Hello, mentor. This is very helpful to us, Coach. What else? Ayan, meron pa. Transferable skills. Do not self-reject. Ayan, nag-note down na si Yan Yan. Ano? And then si Christine Ramos, don't self-reject. Ayan, nag-agree sila kaya talagang ine-echo nila eh. Share ko sa community, nabitin kami. Thank you, Coach
yes,
Han.
Yes, yes.
Ay, ayun, Coach Han, to self-reject talaga. Ayan, o, oh, diba? So, Coach na kanilang tawag sa'yo. Kaya gusto ko rin tawagin kang Coach. Eh. Pero sabi mo, Lawrence lang. So, be it.
Okay. Lawrence lang po.
Sige. Yes. Then, Lawrence, bago tayo, of course, mag-commercial at tumungo doon sa ating discussion. Ito na, itong best practices for acing your interview. Ako, very curious lang ako eh. Kasi, I had experience in recruitment as well because I was also HR before. But syempre, wala na tayo sa game eh. Kumbaga, wala na tayo sa laro eh. Lumabas na tayo because nasa world of entrepreneurship na tayo. So ano ba ang mga napansin mong pagbabago in terms of, number one, yung mga pinipili, alimbawa, if we're gonna talk of the BPO industry or BPO IT industry, ano ba yung mga bago ng hinahanap ng mga profiles ng mga employees ngayon? And then, secondly, mas mahirap na ba ang talent acquisition ngayon compared to before, nung panahon namin? And then, pangatlo, ano din yung napansin mong trend sa mga graduates ngayon na you can say either positive or negative, it's up to you what you want to focus on, na mga employers and then makakuha mo rin talent acquisition professionals out there should watch out for. Go ahead.
Yeah, so let's talk about the trends, no, or even the hiring practices right now in the sector that I'm in. So, based on my view, so to manage expectations, baka sabihin niyo, ay, si Lawrence naman kasi project manager na siya, so hindi na siya nag-hire right now. But of course, being a project manager, we have to understand what we are still looking for, what process we are in. I do have process improvement projects, streamlining projects. So I think hindi naman siya nagbago. However, what I really liked about this industry is that it continuously evolved from your usual contact center agent na sumasagot lang ng calls. So you've had now varied positions like chat support, content moderators, ano pa ba, business-to-business transactions. And they have adjusted to the talent market as well. They acknowledge that. Kasi back then, when I was still in another BPO, and of course, I still never lost touch in the market. Majority of my friends were there. Even I left the industry. Pare-pareho yung pay. That's why it's continuously being shared. Pero right now, some companies, I'm not gonna share which na lang, of course, but there are some organizations na talaga acknowledge na, okay, experience plays a big part as well of their expertise of the people. And I think one of the things that I would want to also share about, I think it's also a key takeaway, is that we're living in also, here in the Philippines though, we're already transitioning into a talent-driven market. So ito yung sinasabi nga natin na hindi, there are some practices back then in recruitment, whether it be 1980s, 1990s, hindi pa ako pinapanganak noong 1990, pero na alam nating nangyayari na nag-iintay ng interview, like for example, ng 2 oras, 3 hours, hindi aalis yung aplikante. Ngayon, try mo siyang gawin, lalayasan ka niyan. There are some, of course, the word of mouth travels fast with social media. So that's why it's very, very critical. Aside from that, talent-driven market, candidates now have more bargaining power because they do understand that some industries, so I'm not going to say all industries, some industries or sub-industries, they do understand now that there is a concept of supply and demand for their role. Yeah. So of course, alam natin at the height of the pandemic, lumobo yung mga ganitong X roles kasi alam natin na okay, for IT positions, ang dami. So, which didn't happen, like, kahit 2016. So back then, I was still hiring for information security. That's my bread and butter starting 2016. So imagine hiring for InfoSec, kung gaano kahirap mag-hire nun. Versus right now, na everyone, not really everyone, like mas malaki yung pipeline. Even language proficiency. So dati, ang hirap maghanap ng Spanish speaker. Ang hirap maghanap ng Japanese speaker. Ngayon, there are already opportunities for these kinds of roles na dati parang, ay, kapag nag-aral ka niyan, parang luho na siya instead of something that's lucrative. So,
yeah, matter of fact, I've seen in your profile na nag-aral ka rin ng Spanish yourself, di ba?
Yes. Yes, briefly lang. After, hindi na talaga kinaya. I was studying masters in international business back then. Tapos sabi ko, hindi na talaga kaya. Hindi na ako makakatulog because I was working at night back then. Pero, siguro we have to also acknowledge that us as talent acquisition professionals or HR professionals, there are some industries na talaga na talent-driven. Kaya nga, I'm not very surprised with the stories na, ay, bakit gano'n na parang nagde-demanda yung candidate ng sweldo? Yeah. Ay, bakit yung mga candidates ngayon, kausap mo kanina, tapos i-interviewin mo ulit mamayang hapon, wala na. So, it's because of that. Yes. Yes, that is correct. So, at the end of the day, it's here to stay. So the question now, and I think organizations naman are consistently addressing this, be it with their candidate experience. So nag-i-improve na yung candidate experience, as well as, of course, employer branding and recruitment marketing. So employer branding right now, kahit saan ka lumingon, all companies are practicing it, nag-hire sila talaga, they invest in talent, so can do that. So sobrang companies right now are also going with the flow na sa talent market. So let me reiterate, hindi lahat ng industries here in the Philippines are talent driven, but there are some industries that's talent driven wherein mas mataas yung demand kaysa supply. So yun.
There you have it. Kita mo naman guys, oh, kalahating oras pa lang yan, dami na nating natututunan sa talent acquisition from Lawrence. Pero hindi pa tayo tapos kasi sa ating pagbabalik, magko-commercial break lang po tayo. We are now gonna discuss in detail, ito, best practices for acing your interview and even negotiating your salary. Ito, more interested ako dito. Alright, so I'll see you again later. Okay, Lawrence, please stay put. Okay, nagbabalik na po. Sinorten ko lang yung ating commercial break kasi alam ko yung interesado kayong matuto na. Kung kayo ay job seeker, paano ba nyo mapupull off ang interview and makakapag-negotiate yung salary. Kaya let's welcome back our coach for tonight, si Miss Lawrence. Ayan. Okay, so very excited na ako pag-usapan itong ating topic, Lawrence. Talagang naalala ko tuloy yung mga time na una ako nag-apply for the first time na sana nakapanood ako ng mga ganitong webinars para I could have done better. But it's not too late yet, okay? Lalo na sa mga fresh grads, sa mga job seekers nowadays. So ano nga ba? Ano ba ang best practice? Oh, by the way, gusto ko lang mag-comment sinabi mo kanina. No? Ang ganda nun eh. Kasi kung yung ibang companies nagpo-focus on customer experience or client experience, tapos meron ding sa employee experience, syempre hindi pwedeng kalimutan yan. And then meron na rin palang inilalagay din yung focus sa candidate or applicant experience, no? So kung ang employee experience EX, ang customer experience CX, eto, hindi pwedeng CX na kasi may CX na rin sa eto, EX, di ba?
Yes.
Alright. So best practices, anong best practice ba sa acing the interviews? Go ahead.
Actually, siguro unang-una na talaga nakakalimutan ng mga aplikante. I do understand na marami tayong application. So, sample ko lang, no, at the height of the pandemic when I started applying for roles, I had applied for 58 companies before I got my role in the start of in a real estate website. So back then, each time that I do the interviews or I even apply to the role, please, although this is not a part of the interview, basahin niyo muna yung job description. No? I do understand you don't self-reject, pero of course you have to also manage your expectations with the position. There are some roles kasi talaga there's a strict requirement, there are some roles that there's not. And one thing as well na nakakalimutan nila, of course, during the interview, although hindi na siya commonly na-ask, I think madalang na siyang i-ask, especially since most companies right now are practicing their branding. Yung what do you know about the company? Pero of course, you have to be in a position wherein you've done your research. How does the company work? Like, not really work internally, but ano ba yung services that they provide? What products did they provide? And who they are as an employer? So it's a simple look kahit sa Google, kahit sa Glassdoor, kahit sa... Even in the job websites, nandun din yung mga company review. So why not take the time, at least before the interview, to research about the company itself? Because at the end of the day, we don't want to be in a position na hindi pala tayo nag-a-align ng vision in terms of my career, in terms of the company's vision. Baka naman it's not a match as early as the interview. Second one is that before you go to the interview, isa rin to, of course, you have to go back and read the job description. I really appreciate those recruiters na ginagawa siya. At some parts of the interview, before it starts, sinesendan ka ng calendar invite, of course, and then yung attachment kasama yung job description.
Yes. Kasi you have talaga importante yan, Lawrence, kaya nga dapat yung coordination din ng HR sa operations or production to ensure na yung job description na ipapakita sa aplikante, candidate, ay up-to-date, di ba?
Yes, that is correct. I've seen candidates back then. Hindi naman sa amin. I've heard candidate stories na, ayun pala, kailangan ng ganitong experience para nalaman ko na lang sa interview. So, please ensure before, of course, my fellow professionals, no, please ensure before posting a job description outside, please ensure that it's up to date. Kasi ginagamit din namin siya. As applicants, of course, in my case, I highlight my unique selling proposition. Ano bang dala ni Lawrence Mutia sa role na to? So, I remember back then when I applied in the IT company, in my second company, ang dinala ko lang nun, I'm used to doing a very dynamic day. I'm used to working with the roles under pressure. Kasi nga volume eh. Of course, I've been in the BPO sector. So, kumbaga, I don't have, of course, the corporate recruiting experience, pero nakita nyo, I started as a fresh grad and I progressed in my role there. So you can see that I'm very teachable and I learn. Same drill. As time went by, I understand now.
Okay, Ms. Lawrence, you're hired. Good answer.
Diba? Parang sabi ko nga, I normally ask my bosses, bakit niyo po ba ako kinukuha? Dito sa role na to, kahit na meron akong kulang, or not really kulang, but some of the requirements I maybe don't fit. And I think this is also one thing that our applicants need to manage. There's no such thing as a perfect applicant, and our hiring manager also need to acknowledge that. There's no such thing as a perfect applicant na tatama sa job description nyo unless pumunta kayo sa LinkedIn, humarap kayo ng applicant at dun yung tailor fit yung JD. But, again, at the end of the day, I'd like to reiterate, we're now living in a talent-driven market. Of course, candidates have more bargaining power, especially in those talent-driven industries. So we have to also be aware of the trends. Kasi minsan, yung mga hiring managers talaga, mayroon ako na experience na it wasn't really an interview, pero alam mo kasi, pag yung recruiter, ilang beses nang nag-hire, yung sobrang tagal na nung opening. So, nakikita mo na eh. So, even online, I'm observing, may opening na ganitong role dito kay X company, pero 2 buwan na siyang bukas. So, why isn't it not being filled. So baka naman hindi na siya ano. And of course I've experienced that back.
O baka na feel na hindi lang in-update yung status doon.
Yeah, I also experienced that. Meron kaming mga ganyang kwento within the industry na syempre at the end of the day we're not perfect. Although right now I'm also very grateful for the invention of a lot of technological advancement. So sobrang okay niya. And of course, companies are also investing on those kinds of technologies to improve the candidate experience. So right now, it's our job as candidates to also understand ano, what do we bring into the table. Kasi baka naman...
Ang ganda nga ng word na ginamit mo, no? Yung unique selling proposition.
Yes, that is correct. So ako back then, nung nag-start akong mag-work, wala naman akong dinala na unique. Sinabi ko lang na every year nagre-recruit naman akong aplikante. Pero I was still a student. Ang hinahire ko, of course, mga kapwa ko students. And back then, when I asked bakit niyo po ako hinahire, sa nila, kasi ano eh, maganda naman yung comm skills mo. So thank you to my parents for ensuring na meron kaming cable in the province that time kasi doon ako nahasa sa comm skills ko. And of course, yun nga, we have to also be prepared doon sa mga common questions. Ito yung mga minsan magugulat ka. Yung tell me something about yourself. So tell me something about yourself. I've had experiences na candidate na tell me something about yourself. Kasi in the industry that I used to belong to, kailangan yung candidate nagsasalita kasi you need to gauge the comm skills. So sobrang, minsan hindi nila rin alam kung paano sumagot. So they have to also, ako noon, we were taught how to provide the feedback after the interview. Yes. So ganun kabilis. So dati, diba, tatawagan ka na lang namin. Ngayon, it's not the story.
Madami sa mga kababayan natin ang naiirita dyan, di ba?
Yes.
Yung tatawagan nila doon, di naman tinatawagan.
Tapos, hindi, magfo-follow up ka via text, isisin ka lang. Kasi kita mo dahil naka-online. So, alam mo yun. But of course, going back to the applicants, you have to prepare for the common interview questions. There are a lot of resources just like this on YouTube. Kahit nga ngayon sa TikTok, meron na. Facebook Reels are there. So alam mo yun, you have to also take use of those kinds of resources. Kasi ito yung sasabihin nila, ay kasi wala akong pang internet. Pero kita mo, nakakapag-Facebook ka. Pero
nakakapaglaro ng mga mobile games,
di ba? Yeah, so you have to also understand na isa pa rin to na you have to be ready in the interview. You demonstrate your comm skills. So, minsan kasi, pag tinanong ka ng English, sasagot ka ng Tagalog. And we acknowledge that. Of course, there are some limitations naman. Particularly in Filipino companies naman, hindi naman required talaga unless you're a part of marketing or corporate communications. Right. Pero, of course, when the speaker or when your interviewer asks something in English, the very least is to try your best to also revert back. Yep. Aside from that...
Alam nga, siyempre, pag nag-apply ka sa BPO, di ba... sasagutin mo ng Tagalog, di ba?
Yes, and alam mo, sobrang ano, there are companies nga na are very flexible with reapplication period. So, hindi ibig sabihin na kapag bumagsak ka because of comm skills, sasabihin, ay, bumagsak ako sa BPO eh. So, dahil nag-apply ako, tapos bumagsak ako, sinabi ang pangat daw ng comm skills ko. No, we encourage them to watch English movies, read English books. So, yun yung lagi kong tinuturo nung ako pa yung recruiter. So, alam mo yun, parang it's up to the candidate na lang talaga if they really wanted to improve. Pero you also have to be ready for those kinds of feedback. Kasi may iba talagang organizations na immediately magpro-provide sa'yo ng feedback. Naalala ko noon, I've had interviews na sinabi nila na, ay, we cannot get you kasi ganito, you lack this. Yeah, but I really do appreciate. Ako sinasabi ko talaga, ang hirap mag-interview. Okay? Hindi siya madali for talent acquisition professionals. It's not an easy job for us. Kasi at the end of the day, we are holding our candidates' careers and futures. Minsan, meron magsasabi na, huy, in-interview mo daw to, tapos ayaw na mag-apply sa ganitong role kasi binagsak mo. So, di ba?
Na-trauma na daw.
Yes. So, of course, for applicants as well, yun nga, don't self-reject. Baka naman kasi Iniisip mo lang sa interview, ay, hindi naman ako, tinawagan lang ako, pero hindi naman ako papasa. No. It doesn't matter na, it doesn't mean na, porque tinawagan ka sa interview, ay, ano, ay, hindi naman ako fit dun sa requirement, hindi ako papasa. No. Kasi, I've seen a lot of folks, teammates, previous acquaintances na wala namang ganung background, pero, oh my God, nakuha niya yung role na yon. Diba? So, yun nga yung concept ng transferable skills. Kasi minsan talaga, yun yung nakakalimutan natin eh. Hindi mo na-review yung JD. Pwede mo naman sabihin, for example, na ay, recruiter ako, pero this kind of volume. Pero, I can do this kasi hindi, I started as a fresh grad. Pero, alam mo yun, it's really a concept of ano ba yung mga ginagawa ko in the university. Ito, for fresh grads, no? Minsan kasi nagkakagulatan during the interview. Akala nila, grades before yung tinitingnan eh. No, I for everyone's reference, I wasn't a cum laude. I wasn't
parang yung trending talk sa social media. Yes. Discarte.
So, ano siya, I wasn't a cum laude. I wasn't really, ano, parang sabi ko, hindi naman sasabihin na sobrang, I was your average student, although I've had extracurriculars. Ano yung transferable skills ko doon? So, nung tinanong ako ng boss ko, ano yung mga ginagawa mo outside of school? Nagtuturo po ako ng Vietnamese. Nagre-recruit ako ng estudyante year on year kasi kailangan namin ng mga writers. So, doon ako nag-start. Doon nag-start yung conversation. Uy, marunong naman pala siyang kumilates ng tao. It's a part of her previous experiences. Noon namang lumipat ako ng mga industries, hindi naman nila tinanong na, ay, may experience ka ba into hiring this? No, they ask, ano ba yung mga previous experiences mo that you can bring value at pwede mong dalhin dito sa role na ina-applyan mo? Lagi ko siyang sinasabi. Minsan, tinanong ako, kasi yung first management experience ko, syempre, wala naman akong formal management experience. Ano yung mga experiences ko before na demonstrated that I can manage people? So, yun nga. There are some instances, pag wala yung boss ko, I run the certain site, or pag Sabado, although sobrang liit lang ng mga tao. So, yung mga ganon. Minsan kasi we tend to forget those small things, pero hindi mo alam those small things will help you ace the interview. Yes, kaya talagang mag-prepare ka. Yung iba parang, ako, based on my experience, I don't normally do interviews ng agad-agad. So, dalawa, tatawagan ako, can I call you in the next 5 minutes? Minsan may tumatawag. Sorry, I know this is a bad practice. I don't answer calls unless meron siyang precedent na text na, hi, can I call you in the
next advice week? Muna yan.
Yes, oh. So it's also a tip to my fellow recruiters, guys. Wala na. Hindi talaga kayo sasagutin ng candidate kung hindi nyo ma-manage yung expectation na kaya na i-call you kasi ang dami na nga yung calls na unnecessary. And this is not because of you, but of course, there are other folks who want to take advantage of that. So please, do the right thing na lang, do the best approach na lang, mag-text muna kayo before calling kasi mamaya tulog pala yan, ginising mo. Yes. Tapos hindi pala ready, yun pa, tapos dun siya bumagsak, so sayang. Aside from that, I make sure as well that when I enter the interview, ito rin yung, since segue na tayo sa negotiation, no?
Right.
Alam ko na kung ano yung expected ko. I have to also show flexibility. What are the things na non-negotiable sa akin? Ito ba is, ano ba yung non-negotiable sa akin right now at the height of my career or in my experiences right now, ako, non-negotiable na sa akin, kailangan ng HMO day one. Hindi na yan pwedeng ay wala kasi I'm not getting any younger. And of course, kung may dependent yan, magkano yung kailangan kong i-shoulder? Yung mga ganon. But of course, yung sweldo, and I really appreciate the recruiters are also asking about it and even showing flexibility na they make it a point that they provide at least a high-level overview kung ano yung kayang i-offer ng kumpanya. Kasi ngayon ang mga candidates, kapag sinabi mong antayin mo na lang yung final interview kasi dun sasabihin, paano kung yung final interview lima? Lima yung dadaanan before the final interview. I have seen that. for a rank and file position, limang interview dinadaanan bago yung
job. Matinding screening process yan.
Yes. So, alam mo yun. And we have to also understand, and I think this is also naman something from the fellow recruiters in my industry, not only in my industry, but in general, na we have to also be an advisor to our hiring managers. Na correct. Hindi porket sinabi na kailangan limang beses namin yung i-interview bago namin ipasa. So, we cannot just say, okay, sige, lima yung interview. Yeah. So, kasi nga, again, we live in a talent-driven market. If your candidate falls out, imagine the time and the effort that you have exerted only to be, na parang napunta lang siya sa wala.
Yes. Yung maganda yung tip na yan, Lawrence, na streamline the process and get rid of bureaucracy. Yes. Because talent-driven na nga, it's all about applicant experience na rin, di ba?
Yes, yes. And I think one thing that candidates also tend to overlook, yun nga, yung minsan kasi talaga, and we get that, tatawagan ka pa lang ng recruiter, tatawagan mo agad, magkano po yung sweldo? So I've seen that. Pero syempre, as a recruiter, hindi na ako nasa-shock because alam ko, may mga ganun talagang candidate. So, ako, I sometimes...
Matinding pa lang kailangan.
Yes. And minsan talaga, and we do acknowledge naman, no, every other candidate is different. It's not an awkward discussion. Pero ako, as much as possible, I manage their expectations that we're doing the interview to also understand your background and qualifications. Although everything is in your resume, we have some follow-up questions. Hindi naman lahat yan masasagot ng resume mo. And we wanted to also, ano, and for candidates as well. Please, ito rin yung minsan nagkaka-disconnect si TA professional at si candidate. The salary expectations are somewhat hindi man unreasonable, pero minsan talagang saan na nakuha yun? I've had experiences, saan na nakuha yun? Like, I get it. There are some industries talaga na porket fresh grad, they offer as high as 40, 50, even 60,000 pesos. Pero of course, there are some industries talaga that they are working on a certain grid or budget for fresh grads. Mm-hmm. So minsan...
So Lawrence, for the advice of course, all the candidates out there.
Yes.
So ako din nakikurious din ako eh. Na, okay, so sino lang ba, I hope I'm able to positively phrase this question. Eh? Sino lang ba ang may K na mag-negotiate ng salary? And then kung may K tayo mag-negotiate ng salary is, paano nga ba nani-negotiate ang salary?
Everyone can negotiate their salary. At the end okay. of the day, siguro nakikita naman natin to on forums na huwag ka munang oo dun sa unang offer, ganyan-ganyan. Pero we have to also be realistic. I know majority of us have applied on online job platforms. Natatoggle doon yung expectations ng sweldo. So kahit hindi yan nakapublish, pwede mo siyang paglaruan doon sa system. So doon pa lang, alam mo na what you're getting into. So the question there is, are you amenable to that kind of salary? Kasi baka naman hindi ka amenable. So why are we doing this? So for recruiters naman as well, we have to also understand that each candidate is unique. May iba na parang tatanggapin yan. Kahit na unang offer mo, may iba namang babalikan ka and say, can we negotiate? So we have to also show flexibility and adaptability. And for us recruiters, total rewards is also the best way to go. Baka naman kasi, we're not the best payers. Hindi ko na sasabi, this is a quote that I got from one of my leaders from a previous life. We're not the best payers, pero oh my God, anong benefits meron sila? Meron yeah. kang retirement, 5 years pa lang.
Yung company initiated, no? Matindi.
Yes, meron kang 25% night differential. Eh, paano wow. ko nagtatrabaho kapag gabi? So, di ba, it's really not that bad to listen to your recruiter. Kasi minsan yung recruiter naman, hindi naman din sila yung may final decision eh.
Yes.
And of course, before you say no to an offer from the salary or the actual salary package, intindihin nyo rin ano ba yung benefit. Baka naman, ako I've worked in a company na merong educational assistant. So imagine if I was still there, di ba? So ang laki na nabawas nun sa tuition.
They can, you know, they subsidize if you want to take up MBA, no?
Yes.
And the like.
Yes. Meron ako mga companies that I work with na merong, yun nga, 25% night differential. So saan ko kukuha nun? So you have to also understand what's in it for me?
Yes, what's in it for you? Meron din naman mga companies, ang laki na yung base pay, pero yung benefits, mandatory lang.
Yes, diba? I've seen that. Tapos, of course, yung stability is there. Imagine, ako noon, I moved to the pharma sector just because I know this is one of the most stable industries at the height of the pandemic. Pharma eh. Pero, alam mo yun, it showed me more than just stability. It showed me growth. It showed me na, ay, kahit pala hindi ko to na-experience before, pwede pala siya because I've seen teammates of mine go to another country, doon na nag-ano na role. So, hindi nila yun, some people don't appreciate that. I think it's a question of motivation as well. Pero before you say no to an offer, listen to the entirety of it. I think this also applies to the fresh grads kasi minsan, kala nila pag sinabing 20,000 lang yung sweldo, parang, ay, okay, tapos na ang usapan, 20,000 lang pala yung sweldo, pero hindi nila intindihan na, oh, pwede mong i-enroll yung magulang mo sa HMO, and you know how expensive it is for the healthcare in the Philippines. So, yung mga ganun, ako, back then, ang priority ko lang, gusto ko lang ng ganitong X amount of sweldo. Pero na nagtatagal na ako sa career ko, ay, sana meron akong ganito na nakukuha ko sa ibang employer. Meron akong mga na-experience na na malaki ding magpasweldo, pero ang liit ng benefits. I've had experiences that I had to take a pay cut. Hindi naman sobrang laki, no? Pero I've had to take a pay cut. Pero isipin mo yung what's in it for me when I join the industry or when I join that company. So, right. I think it's also a question na kapag kasi nag-negotiate ka, you have to also manage your expectations well na you know that the company is working on a budget. Pero ano ba yung outside of the monthly salary? Kasi ito rin, I think it's a Filipino culture naman, no? Na tinitingnan lang nila yung buwan ng sweldo. Pero yeah. Guys, alam naman natin
true,
yung subjected
to
tax.
True that, yeah.
So we have to also understand, ano ba yung mga hindi subjected to tax na pwede nating ma-appreciate, diba? For example, if there are non-taxable allowances, meron ba nun? Meron ka bang right subsidy? Yung mga additional plus. Meron yes. Ako nun na mga, I've had experience, I think this is one of the things na masasabi ko na siguro sobrang na-struck sa akin or nag-stay sa akin. I'm not gonna say na lang kung anong taon. I've had a candidate back then na pumasa na siya. The candidate already went up to offer. I discussed the offer. For 2,000 pesos, nag-negotiate siya. So the offer, I can't remember what the offer was. Basta yung difference dun sa inaakit niyang sweldo is 2,000.
2,000, okay.
Yes.
Maliit lang.
Yes. And the hiring manager said, wag na natin i-consider. Kasi ang dami nila dun sa role. Yung role na yun kasi pag inopen mo, 150 is the minimum number of applicants. So alam nilang may pipeline eh.
Yes.
So sadly, that candidate did not move forward to the next level, which is the onboarding. Kasi it's not because of the negotiation, pero we are also acknowledging na meron ka kasing annual increase. Yeah, it will also depend on the performance. Tayo kasi pag sinabing ito lang yung pay, minsan sasabihin nila, ay, kasi ganito na yung ginagawa ko before eh. Pero, this is the reason why you have a certain period on your probationary period. Minsan, nakakalimutan nila yun. You have to also, what you have in your previous employer is a different story right now. You're bringing in your talents or transferable skills in a new organization. So ako, ang naging mantra ko as a job seeker is that, okay, sige, try ko inego. If it progresses, okay. Kung hindi, I assess, is this something that's worth my time? Is this something that's gonna benefit my career in the long run? If I chose the latter, I go. That's okay. Kasi at the end of the day, may matututunan ako. And I think I practiced that twice. And sobrang grateful ako kasi yung mga employers na yun talaga yung nagbigay sa akin ng progression that I didn't expect that I would have. So minsan kasi, when you negotiate your pay din kasi, for lack of a better term, we have to be very realistic, no?
Yeah, realistic and relevant, yeah.
Yeah, so isa din to sa sinasabi ko dun sa mga nakaka-work ko na sinasabi nga nila, Lawrence, paano to? Kasi I do have this X qualifications and ganyan-ganyan. So, ako ang ginagawa ko, tinitingnan ko rin what's in the talent market right now. Ano yung mga similar job openings on same industries or maybe different industries na na ito yung pwede kong puntahan. Kasi, for example, I've had experiences na in-interview ako for a company pero hindi nila kayang i-offer yung sweldo kasi what I'm getting back then is the budget that they have. So, we have to also align as early as the initial interview. So, I think this is also one reminder, no, to our recruiters na manage the right expectations kasi you don't want to be in a position na yung candidate mo is, okay, ito yung expected niya, nag-align kayo, tapos during the job offer, hindi yun yung offer mo.
Yes.
But ano ba yung i-offer mo pang more? So may mga ganun naman, may mga, pero we have to also understand that candidates are very different each time. May iba na okay, may iba na hindi, pero it's our job as recruiters to also help them see what we can help them with, what we can provide them with. So for
rewards,
So for our candidates, so you have to also do your research. And daming job openings on job platforms that can help you toggle. Meron dong filter kung magkano yung expected salary from this range to this range. So, alam mo na na, okay, pag yung role ko ganito, ganito yung years of experience ko, ganito. Pay scale is also a good resource. Tinitingnan na ngayon, pati yung industry. So, if you really want to progress, for example, in a certain role, ano ba yung mga industries who will pay higher for the same role that I'm doing right now? So, alam mo yun, minsan yung mga tao, yun nga, don't limit yourself. Don't self-reflect. Kasi minsan nagkakalimutan na, uy, baka pwede ko pala siyang, pwede pala yung skill na yun na ilipat sa ibang industry. So, and that's what I've done. I know my story is somewhat common naman. No? I'm not the perfectest candidate. Pero we have to also acknowledge that candidates right now, or us as people, if we're looking for growth, we have to also be ready to step up and explore other industries, other organizations. So, aside from that, we have to also be ready to step up our game. Kasi minsan yung iba, lilipat ng kumpanya, same mindset pa rin yung dinala. Tapos magugulat ka kung ano yung mindset mo before hindi siya nag-work. So, of course, it's a question of adjustment. So, you have to also understand what are the company's organizational goals. Lagi na tayo ngayon may new employee orientation. Ginagawa na yan halos ng mga companies and even the onboarding. Magugulat ka. May padala yung kumpanya na something. Or minsan, sa video call yung onboarding and even people take the time to help you with onboarding. So you have to also understand what the culture is in the organization. So you as a candidate, it's really, of course, to sum things up, you have to research and manage your expectations. To you determine your unique selling proposition. Ano ba yung dinadala ko sa isang organization na pwedeng wala yung ibang candidates, pwedeng meron, pero alam ko that I can go further. Aside from that, prepare common questions. Finally, show adaptability and flexibility. Again, hindi lahat ng organization might work for you. But of course, if you've done your research, you felt that it was the fit and you got the role, you have to also understand ano ba yung mga pwedeng limitations, such as, of course, yung salary range. Ano ba yung pwede ko pang i-take advantage aside of the salary? It may be, okay, alam ko kasi itong organization na to, sobrang galing niya mag-develop ng mga tao. Ang tagal-tagal ng mga tao sa org. I think this is also one thing, no? In this kind of market na alam naman natin na hindi halos nagtatagal, the average tenure, if I'm not mistaken, is 3 to 4 years na lang ngayon, mas bumababa pa. Because of the Gen Zs entering the market, there's also the great resignation that happened na nagsimula siya ng pandemic. So, right now, organizations are also really banking on candidate and employee experience. So, dun pa lang, ano ba yung mga, for example, I've seen companies not really here in the Philippines, but of course, it's somewhat similar, na magtataka ka, bakit mo lang nagre-resign doon? Like, kung may mag-resign man, siguro 3% lang year on year. Or siguro it's a cultural thing. Pero isipin mo, 20 years na yung mga tao, 15 years na yung mga tao. So alam mo yun, it's also a good conversation. Bakit po nagtatagal yung mga tao? Ako, I also ask that. Bakit po umalis yung huling tao din sa role na to? So alam mo yun. So that's also...
The reasons will branch out there.
Yes, that's right. And finally, yun nga, just a gentle reminder, don't self-reject. Minsan talaga magugulat ka yung mga roles na hindi mo ina-expect na yun na makukuha mo, yun yung nasa'yo. Yun yung mga bagay na, oh my God, hindi ko ina-expect na makukuha ko yung role na to.
Yeah. Just like you, di ba, Lawrence, yung story.
Yes, pero sobrang, alam mo yun, those leaders behind me, thank you so much po. Alam nila yun, they know from the very start na this is something na sobrang grateful ako long term. Sabi ko nga dun sa boss ko, wala naman pong Lawrence Mutia kung wala naman po itong director na to. Director na kasi yung boss ko. From a senior recruiter, naging director na siya. Kung wala naman siya dito, hindi naman ako nabigyan ng ganung opportunity. So sobrang thankful ako. So, yun. So, I think we have a lot of things that we discuss. So, grabe. I hope you guys have
learned. Parang ano eh, talagang si Lawrence talaga, talent acquisition expert. Para tayong isang oras lang, pero para tayong nag-mini MBA sa talent acquisition, di ba? Both from the perspective of the recruiter and the perspective of the candidate.
Yes.
At dahil dyan, Lawrence, you deserve this. Maraming salamat. Ano lang po, Lawrence, ang ating mga followers, mga nanonood ngayon at manonood pa, no, pagkatapos na ma-record ito, ay, kumbaga, they are very interested and curious how to get a hold of you, how to contact you, how to affiliate or associate with you. So, saan ka ba nila pwedeng sundan, Lawrence? Go ahead.
Of course, I'm very Message. Active on LinkedIn. Of course, I'm very active on LinkedIn, just like Myron. So just search my name, Lawrence Amy Mutia, or you can just type Lawrence Mutia. It's also there. I also, mostly on LinkedIn talaga ako very active. So please feel free to connect. I also have my email address, lawrencetherecruiter@gmail.com. But mostly on LinkedIn talaga. So that's like my Facebook and my Instagram. So
pag talent acquisition professional talaga, tambay talaga LinkedIn. Nandun ang yes, talent.
Yes, so yun.
That's right. And of course, you're also a resource speaker, trainer, and consultant on recruitment, right? So, meron ka ba mga gustong i-promote? Like may mga paparating ka bang events, webinars, seminars, etc.? Go ahead.
Yeah, I do have two sessions this April. So I do have one, New Trends in Talent Acquisition, in Sourcing Talent Acquisition and Onboarding. And I also have Employer Branding 101. So for those who are interested to learn more about those topics, particularly for employer branding, no, I know there's so much discussions about it. How can we start our employer branding strategy? You may also connect with me via LinkedIn for more details. So this is a public training, hindi naman siya private. And of course, for those who want some consultations about improving your resume, acing interviews, I also help candidates negotiate salary. I help them find out ano ba yung market worth mo. So yung mga ganun, just connect with me on LinkedIn as well.
All right, now please connect kay Lawrence sa LinkedIn. Once again, on behalf of Team MSS Business Solutions and hashtag Myron Kaming Advice, maraming salamat, Lawrence! And enjoy the rest of your Saturday with your beloved cats, syempre. A strict reliever and source of relaxation mo. Thank you, yes. Thank you from the bottom
thank
of our
heart. Thank you, for having me po.
You're welcome, Lawrence. Kaya sa mga job seekers out there, syempre, talagang yung value makukuha mo hindi sa panonood, pakikinig, pero sa pag-a-apply ng mga wisdom na natutunan natin kay Lawrence. Okay? Thank you, Lawrence!
Thank you.
Okay, bye for now.
Bye.
Ayan. Okay, so muli, ating pong napanood at napakinggan ang ating talent acquisition expert and professional, si Ms. Lawrence Amy Mutia. So kung hindi nyo po naalala lahat ng mga pinromote po ni Lawrence, once again, you can follow her on LinkedIn. Tapos tingnan nyo sa feed niya yung mga nabanggit niya na mapaparating niyang seminars that you guys can enroll into if you want to know more about such topics she enumerated. Okay? So, tapos na naman po ang ating isa na namang gabi ng inspiration, motivation, and learning. Kaya abangan nyo po ang ating susunod na guest next week Dito lamang po yan sa hashtag Myron Kaming Advice. So for now, ang inyong lingkod, your buddy to success, Mentor Myron Santana. Magpapaalam na po at magpapahinga na rin. Okay, so see you next week. Bye!